Hello there, beautiful Minecraft addicts. Now, apparently today I have a thing for making redstone videos. Now, this is not necessarily a tutorial, more of a demonstration and also a call for help. Now, first of all, what we have here is the standard double door with pressure plates. Okay, so either pressure plate on it doesn't matter which pressure plate you step on, both of the doors open. Okay, now I showed you how to do this in a previous tutorial. I made one small modification. Let me just get my quick bar. So instead of having this circuit loop around here, I saved some redstone and just made that connection there, and it seems to work. So that's clean, that's fast, that's okay. Now, this is basically the same. Basically, it's not basically. It started as the same principle, the double door. Okay, opening the double door. But I wanted to do something a little bit special when I want to enter the house. Okay, so in order to enter the house, you usually do like this and you enter the house. But I wanted to do something special. Now, I didn't want to just put a button there and I don't know, when you press the button it opens for a split second and then it closes. That bugs me because I have to find this in that. Come on, get through the door, you see? So yeah, that annoys me very much. So I wanted to do something else. I wanted to do something like this. I press a button here. Okay, and those doors stay opened. Okay, so they indefinitely stay open, and when I pass through, the door closes behind me. Now let's try that again. So opens the door. Now there is a problem, and that's where I need your help. I want you to watch the timing. So those doors open perfectly, but these ones, did you see that? And also when they close, they don't close at the same time. They open one after another. Now this is perfectly normal, but I due to the fact that I know the wiring, but I don't want to do that. I just want them to do naturally like this, open at the same time. So again, I'm gonna show you the wiring under the pressure plates to redstone. That's a basic inverter, goes in there. This one directly goes into the red torch, redstone torch. Now here, it's another thing entirely. We start with a basic setup, okay? Two redstone. That one directly goes in there. And that one with an inverter should go in there. But there's a few things on the way. Now, there are two new things on the way. That's a AND gate, a simple AND gate, and that's a memory cell. I don't know exactly how it's called. It's called something with latch. I don't know what latch means. I just call it a memory cell because that's what it does. So first of all, let's show the AND gate. So the AND gate means that when you have both inputs, this being the inputs, okay, when you have them when both of them are on, the output should be on. But when one of them is off or both of them are off, the output, this being the output, is always off. Okay, so let's do that so you can see this being, this is the output. Okay, so now I'm gonna just one of them that should remain off. Okay, that's off, and the same thing with the other, off. Okay, but when I both of them are on, that goes on. Okay, so that's the basic AND gate. So 3 dirt, 2 on top, 2 torches on top, 1 in the middle, and a redstone in the middle as well. Also the memory latch. Let's build another memory latch. The memory cell, I'm sorry. Okay, so 2 blocks, 2 redstone torches, and a way to connect those 2 blocks. Okay, so let's do the input and the output. Okay, the memory cell, basically it works like this. When you press the off part, it remains like that, even though that doesn't produce any more current. Let me just show you exactly what I mean. Let's throw that away. Okay. And also here the same thing. Okay, so you press here, the memory cell remembers this part as being active. You don't input any more pressure on the plate, and that part remains active. You go on the other side, you press, that part remains active, and even though you don't input anything else. So that's a memory cell. The memory cell, of course, this is the most basic, the most how you call it, simple and compact. Yes, you can build it larger if you feel like it, or if you need a larger memory cell. Okay, you can build it like this. I don't know why would you need something like that. Okay. And that's the basic memory cell, maybe. You can build it as large as you want, but that's the basic principle. Okay, so one AND gate and one memory cell. I don't know if I should explain this. This is more of an advanced circuit. That's the AND gate over there. It has 2 inputs, that one over there and that one over there, and this is the memory cell. Okay, so 1 block, 2 blocks, 1 redstone torch there, 1 redstone torch here, and the connection between the 2 of them. And you see now that part of the memory cell is active, and when I activate the button, it moves to the other part. So that's no longer active, but the other one is. Yes, so this is what I wanted your help for, how to make to synchronize these 2 doors. Yeah, the delay comes from the resto signal being having to pass through the AND gate, and also through that inverter. It's it has a long way to actually over there as well. it has a long way to go to travel, and that's why it takes so long. It doesn't bother you very much. I mean, it doesn't stop you. Okay, if you run full speed, maybe a little bit, but at normal speed, it doesn't. At normal speed, it doesn't actually do any harm. I'm curious if this one at full speed. Yeah, so you see that one as full speed, as sprint. It opens with no problems whatsoever. So yeah. I hope this intrigues you, and also makes you wanna play some more with the basic Minecraft redstone. Probably I could do this with Red Power. I'm downloading it tonight and playing around with it a little bit. But I don't want to do that with a mod. I just wanted to play with a basic redstone. Okay guys, please rate, comment and subscribe. It's free and it really helps a lot. And don't forget to be awesome. Ciao.